The Higher Education Students Financing Board has announced that 1,836 students have been selected to benefit from the Students' Loan Scheme as allotted in the budget for the financial year 2024-2025. According to Engineer Dr. Charles Wana, ATM Chairperson of the Board, for the Students' Loan Scheme, 6,661 students applied for the loan. However, only 1,838 qualified. Among these, 1,048 are males and 790 are females. He added that 1,372 students would benefit from degree programs, whereas 466 would benefit from diploma programs. He emphasized that the selection criteria was based on the district quota system, as well as the students' economic vulnerability.
This academic year, the board adopted the 3 loan award selection model, in which the Parliament's recommendation, in line with Parliament's recommendation and aspiration. In selecting the successful loan application, the board considered every application on the basis of its social economic situation, where the Integrated Loan Management Information System awards points to determine the learner's level of vulnerability.
In his remarks, John Chrysostom Muingo, the State Minister for Higher Education, said the government has allocated 7.250 billion shillings to finance the students' education in the first year. He added that beneficiaries have to take note that the loans have to be paid back to create a revolving fund.
Colleagues, the board has to date awarded loans to 16,437 students from its inception, who are spread across 25 universities and 36 other tertiary institutions.
The presiding judge, Isaac Mwata, continued with the Henry Katanga murder case hearing. Today, the prosecution uncovered gaps in the testimony of Andrew Kizimula Mubiru, the police's acting forensic director, and the 8th prosecution witness who testified yesterday in the court. During the cross-examination today, Mubiru was asked by the defense lawyer about the DNA test that he conducted on the bed sheets that were recovered from Molly Katanga, and he said the results implicate Molly Katanga and 2 other people whose DNA samples were not obtained.
You can confirm that that batch includes tests done on Molly Katanga?
Yes, that's the same batch.
The control samples?
Yes, the batches, all control samples in that batch as well.
In your understanding, is it irregular to run the control sample in the same batch with these other samples?
It's not regular if you're doing electrophoresis.
But otherwise it's irregular?
When we do PCR, we do them separately.
Otherwise it's irregular?
For electrophoresis, it's not irregular.
But it otherwise is irregular. Please answer.
For PCR, it would be regular. Not.
The defense also told the court that the equipment used in the DNA testing of the obtained samples could have been contaminated to give false results.
Or would I be right to suggest that a negative test checks for contamination or pollution?
Is that so? A negative test would ideally have to come out clean.
Yes or no?
To indicate.
Does it check before?
Yes, it's one of the indicators.
Thank you.
They accused Mubiru of using outdated software that he obtained on the internet to analyze the DNA samples, which he concurred with the defense.
Would I be correct to say that you use a software called Euro4Mix?
Yes, that is correct.
Can you confirm to this court that Euro4Mix is an open source software?
Yes, it is open source with a continuous model.
Thank you.
The prosecution accused Molly Katanga of murdering her husband on November 2nd, 2023 by shooting him at their home located in Buya Chuatu Road in Nakawa Division, Kampala District. Top U.S. officials today urged Israel to make changes in its operations in the occupied West Bank after the military acknowledged its fire likely killed an American activist there. U.S. President Joe Biden said he thought the killing of Shenua Igiigi was an accident, but both Secretary of the State Anthony Blinken and Pentagon Chief Lloyd Austin called it unprovoked and unjustified. After an initially measured response to Igi's death on Friday, pending a fact-finding exercise, Blinken said the United States would raise it at senior levels with its key ally. The Israeli military said it had found that it was highly likely that she was hit indirectly and unintentionally by IDF Israeli army fire. It added that the fire was not aimed at her, but it aimed at the key instigator of the riot. Israeli government spokesperson David Mensah said the Israeli regrets the killing and promised that an investigation is underway.
The IDF greatly regrets what has happened here. Clearly, this has been a terrible mistake, and it is investigating the issue fully, the results of which will come out very, very shortly.
Igi, who was 26 and also held Turkish citizenship, was killed as she attended the site of weekly demonstrations against Israeli settlements, which are illegal under international law but supported by right-wing members of Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu's government.